Chad here with Purple Collar Life, and in today's video we're going to talk about hearing protection. It's summertime and I spend a lot of time on the mower, on the John Deere, cutting firewood with the chainsaw, using the trimmer, using the blower, and those are all things that can get a little noisy, so it's important to protect your ears. In this video we'll be talking about the IsoTunes Pro 2.0 and three different versions of the 3M WorkTunes. So stay tuned, I'll tell you what I like about each one and ultimately what my favorite is. If you like videos like this, go ahead and give us a like down below. We'd really appreciate it. Now let's talk about hearing protection. I'm gonna move the rest of this review into the shade because you know how I feel about the heat and the sun. So I wanna start out by saying that I do prefer the WorkTunes by 3M to the IsoTunes Pro 2.0, and I'll explain why. If you've watched the channel for a while, you know I got these IsoTunes Pro 2.0 hearing protection pieces. I really like that some of the other channels on YouTube use them and like them, like GP Outdoors. So I'll give a little shout out here to GP Outdoors. I wanted to give these a try because he really likes them and lots of other people like them too. So let's talk about the good things about the IsoTunes Pro 2.0. It does have 27 noise reduction rating, which is a good reduction rating. 16 hours of music and talk time between charges, so it holds a charge a good time. It is dust, sweat, and waterproof IP67. It uses Bluetooth 5.0 technology, so a good connection between your phone or your device and the IsoTunes Pro 2.0. I've never had a problem with them cutting out, losing music, losing connection. So that's a nice thing about them. Another nice thing is that the microphone section is also noise canceling. So if you do take a phone call and you're in a noisy area, it kind of blocks out that background noise as you're talking to whoever's on the other end of the line. And then the last thing I want to mention, it does incorporate a thing called Safe Max, which limits the volume output to 85 decibels. So if you are listening to something and you keep turning it up because the area you're in is so loud, it will not allow the volume to go above 85 decibels, which protects your hearing. Now let's talk about what I don't like about these IsoTunes Pro 2.0, and it's probably a personal thing. I have trouble getting them twisted and to stay in my ears solidly to protect me from the noise. I find that they start slipping out over time and loosening up. In the package was a charge cord and different sizes of earbuds and different types. Now I've tried those different sizes. The smaller ones fall out even easier. Now I don't think my ear canals are excessively large, but maybe that is the case, I'm not sure. Because I cannot get these to stay in tight. They're not comfortable. They actually hurt the inside of my ears after a while. I'm constantly pushing them in tighter. I do like that they had these little bands for behind your earlobe that holds it in place. So even though it's sliding out, it doesn't fall off your head. As far as the control, there's a power on button and a plus and minus. You can answer phone calls just by hitting the button. And also on here is the charging port. So you just plug your USB cord in right there and charge it up. And it does not take too long to charge. It does have an LED indicator when your power is on, as well as audio, it tells you power on, Bluetooth connected. So, not that there's anything wrong with these, but for me, they're not comfortable and they end up not being as quiet as the WorkTunes because I can't keep them tight enough in my ear. You could probably guess from the start of the video that the WorkTunes would be my favorite because I wear these when I'm mowing. And I switched for a while where the IsoTunes because I like to wear a hat when I'm mowing, didn't want the sun to be in my eyes and on my head. And then a bunch of you commented, it is possible to wear the WorkTunes over a hat. And I'm embarrassed to say I never even thought of that. I was thinking, how would I wear the WorkTunes and my hat? I wasn't thinking, how would I wear my hat and the WorkTunes? And you can see it works perfectly fine. So that has made me wear the WorkTunes 99% of the time. I still like the IsoTunes Pro 2.0 when I'm doing any cutting with the chainsaw and I have my helmet on because the IsoTunes 2.0 goes around the back of my neck, under the helmet, no problems. Whereas these could not go over the helmet. Now let's talk a little bit about the differences between these 3M WorkTunes that I have. These were the ones I got first. These are the ones that I saw other people using on YouTube, like Outdoors with the Morgans, Mike Morgan. And the thing I like about these are their function is their radio as well as Bluetooth. So I listen to the radio most of the time on these, but they are Bluetooth connected to my phone. So that if someone calls me, it does tell me that I'm getting a phone call, and it does let me answer and talk on that phone call. But most of the time, I'm listening to the radio. So if I'm in an area that there is no radio signal, I can click the source button on here and change it to Bluetooth. And then I can play my Sirius XM or any of the music that's on my phone. This next version is for Jennifer. She prefers just to listen to the radio. So this WorkTune set is AM FM stereo only, no Bluetooth connection. It's a little bit less expensive. It still lets you listen to all your favorite radio stations. And I found, I don't know if because it's newer, but the top design is actually more comfortable than the Bluetooth and AM FM radio version. You can see it's got better padding. It's softer. And I find that these sponges outside the over ear part are more secure. And that could be just because it's brand new and I've worn mine quite a bit. Now the newest addition to the family is this version, WorkTunes Bluetooth only. Now these are the ones that Mackenzie wears. They've got a 24 decibel noise reduction rating and they connect only to Bluetooth. So she uses these connected to her phone to listen to her favorite music as we're mowing. The downside to these ones, in my opinion, is that they are USB charge only. Whereas the radio WorkTunes and the radio and Bluetooth WorkTunes take AA batteries. Now you would think that I would like the rechargeable version better than the AA battery version. But actually, to me, the AA battery version is much more convenient. I don't even take these in the house most of the time. I leave them on the mower out here in the garage. So to take them in somewhere to charge them USB is really inconvenient. I like the ability to just bring out two AA batteries. I've got a stockpile of AA batteries because we know that all of our trail cams use 6, 8, 10 AA batteries at a time. So I buy them the Amazon Basics AA batteries, and I've got plenty of them in storage. So I just bring two more out when I need them, but actually I've never even had to replace these in a year's time. They've held up really good. They hold a charge. I don't let them sit out during the winter time. The cold weather would be bad for them. So my preference is the AA batteries over the USB charging. I'll put links to all of these down below in the Amazon affiliate links. If you're thinking about ordering one, I'd really appreciate it if you use that link. It doesn't cost you anything more, but it does give me credit for sending you over to Amazon. So for me, the 3M WorkTunes are a better fit for my ear and my application than the IsoTunes Pro 2.0. And thank you to everyone in a previous video who suggested that I could simply put these on over top of my hat. I can't believe I never thought of it. A little bit about the operation of these ones. These are my favorite. These are the ones I use all the time. This bottom button, you push in for power and you turn for volume. This button on the side is your radio frequency, so you turn it. And the nice thing is there's a voice that tells you what your current frequency is. So if I turn it, it'll say 98.3. Turn another click, 98.4. So it tells you where you are on the frequency dial as you make adjustments. You can also choose your source here. So AM, FM, or Bluetooth in this particular case. And in Jennifer's radio-only version, AM or FM, and hers is the same power and volume and tuning knob. Hearing protection is really important when you're running equipment. It's important to protect your ears. You don't get your hearing back as you damage your eardrums and your hearing capacity. So it's important even at a young age to protect your hearing. And I wish I had started earlier wearing things like this when I was running log splitters, chainsaws, tractors, and mowers. If you like videos like this, give us a thumbs up. Comment down below on what you use for hearing protection. Share with your friends. And if you're not already a subscriber, click that subscribe button, and then we'll see you the next time. Thanks for watching.